There are five things you need to know about SQL and AI. Do you know what they are? This week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Mazma Zahid from the SQL DB product group. Mazma, thanks so much for joining us again.
Thank you, Anna, for having me. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. It's great to have you on the show. For folks who haven't seen Mazma before, she's a great leader in our team, and she's leading in the fronts of SQL DB, AI, and developer, and she always brings us really exciting AI content and exciting demos. And I don't think today is going to be any exception. So Mazma, what did you want to talk about today?
I thought this is a lot of what we have talked about in the past about several AI stuff. So I thought, why not summarize everything in one session? So I'm going to talk about five things you need to know about SQL and AI.
I love it. Bob always says lists of three and five are great. So I'm all for it. What's the first thing?
Let's get started. So the first thing is, if you want to actually take your SQL data and build powerful RAG-based patterns in Azure AI Search, you can do that. We have a first-party support in Azure AI Search through the index that you can create. It's very simple. You can take any of your SQL data, be it in SQL MI, SQL DB, SQL Server. You can create a thing called index in Azure AI Search, and this index can be created one time, and it can be kept up to date based on the CDC technology that we have. And after that, this AI search comes with integration with Azure Open AI Search, and you can build complete RAG pattern search on your SQL data. So this is a great way of getting started. You can build chat applications. There are a lot of demos that we've done on this, so definitely check this out. So that's the first thing you need to know about it. And this is great integration that comes out of the box in Azure.
Awesome. And just a quick question on that first one, is that it's pretty much a low code, no code, if you want it to be, type of solution, right?
Yeah, end to end to build this, I have a great blog on this. It takes like 5 to 10 minutes to create the index, depending on the size of the data and all of that. And then you can get started with the chat application.
Awesome. Cool. Okay. All right. We got one. What's the second?
Second, this is the latest and greatest features that we've announced at Microsoft Ignite and PaaS Summit. We have now the native vector support in Azure SQL, also in private preview in MI, and it's also coming to SQL Server 2025. So ground to cloud to Fabric, and SQL DB and Fabric also supports that. That's the vector capability. So I have the preview is available, public preview is available of the native vector type. And also coming soon is the disk and AI-based index for vectors. So I have a quick demo for this to show. I can go over that in terms of what it means for you as a developer, as a data enthusiast, or somebody who's building these applications. You can now really build these operational RAG patterns, going beyond chatting with your data to really look at your operational data as it comes. You can do a semantic search on it. You can do structured queries, natural language to SQL type of things on it, and then of course the RAG pattern, all built in into SQL. So let's see this in action. In this example, I have an insurance company called Contoso Insurance. Let's imagine that Contoso Insurance actually has a chatbot, and I'm an agent and I'm talking to this chatbot. I want to know about a customer. In this case, the customer name is John Doe. So I'm going to meet with this customer later today. I'm going to ask, I'm meeting with John Doe, can you please tell me more about this customer? And this chatbot actually translates your natural language into a SQL query and goes back and says, we have two John Doe's. Which John Doe are you talking about? Then you can go in and chat with this chatbot very naturally, intuitively, and learn more about this customer and go into the claims history, find more information about it, and go on. And what's actually really happening is that natural language query is getting converted into a simple SQL statement. Of course, you can create more complex SQL statements. We have several examples in our samples where you can use JSON and other complex SQL queries as well. And what it helps the particular agent in this case is just taking that. We actually have the AI model integration built into engine that converts that natural language into a SQL statement. And what you can do as a customer in this case is going beyond a natural language to SQL query is really using RAG pattern. And here you can see the agent is asking about the premium changes for this customer over the last 3 years. From all the communication history, you can see that this chatbot can go and summarize this. Now, this is not a simple SQL statement. This requires more semantic meaning of understanding of the communication history and what you've been talking to. And it can also use the RAG pattern to send all of this data to GPT model or any of your favorite language models and summarize that. And in this case, you can see that it actually summarized that for this particular customer, this is the summary of all the communication that we have had with this customer. And based on the history, it seems like this is what you should be talking to and what possible issues could be when it comes to this customer. And what's it actually is really doing is the thing what we call operational RAG. So as soon as your transaction lands in this data, any communication history, and either email or phone call or anything, you can now start using the capability of RAG pattern with vector search directly on this data. And this is basically what it is calling in the background is a stored procedure for that particular customer ID, just using natural language. Very simple to build. We have the sample example and links that will be published with this video. And this is the SP invoke rest endpoint that you've seen before it on this show. And using the latest vector type and the vector distance functions to find similar communication with this customer and getting to that.
Wow, that was so cool. That was so much in one demo that was there. And I love that you said this is all a sample. So folks, we will put a link to that in the description below and you can try this out. I'm guessing it's pretty easy to spin it up based on the code sample.
Yes, it is. And there's a simple one-line command with which you can we can install this and work with your data as well. Next, I want to talk about Copilots. I know we have talked about this and Joe Sack has come on this show and talked about this. This is a great example of a RAG pattern or AI application that we have built for you to use as a data developer, database administrator, or anything. We have two experiences right now in public preview. Both of them are Azure-based. We also have a similar experience in SQL DB and Fabric, and Microsoft Fabric as well, where you can find Copilot experiences. So one is called self-help. So let's say if you want to know about if your database is slow or a particular query is running slow or an index that is missing, anything that you want to get help with or get started really fast to actually improve and help with your productivity. That's the experience. And the second experience is natural language to SQL. So this is really the second experience that you have. And these are all the different types of examples. We have about, I think at this point, 100 plus of these skills. I know in Azure portal, we support about 60, 70 of these, and then a lot of those coming to SSMS Copilot, as you've seen in the past. So all of these are available for you as a DBA, as a data developer, as a accidental DBA. If you've been asked or given a database to go figure it out, you can start using Copilot to get you started and improve your productivity.
Awesome. I love it. So the AI things you need to know also includes things you can just use. So that's great. Okay. So we talked about one, two, three. I think there's two more.
There's two more. So the next is whenever I've presented any of the AI presentations, this comes up almost in every presentation. So what about security? People are really worried. People are really worried or concerned about the privacy of data, especially in RAG pattern applications. So the first and foremost thing for you to know is your data is not never used to actually train any of these models. In any of the copilots, when you give us feedback, that feedback is only stored for that particular copilot only if you consent to. There's literally a message that comes up and says that if you want to store that prompt, none of your data is actually stored with it. It's only the prompt. So again, those things are really important. But when you're building these Gen AI applications or RAG pattern applications, the beauty of doing that with SQL or T-SQL within this vector capabilities and all of this is it actually builds upon the built-in security considerations that you've already put in SQL. For example, in SQL, you could have ledger tables, you could have row-level security. So the demo example that I was giving you, actually that database has three John Does. In this case, since the agent that was accessing the data only had access to two, in the first prompt, if you saw it, gave the answer to say there are two John Does. And you can go even further level, like you can have data masking, but any things that you know and have been using in SQL for many, many years, they apply to these RAG pattern applications. And this is really, really, we have a great customer example case study that will be coming out. They're actually using row-level security with the chat with your data scenarios. And this is something you should definitely explore if you're worried about what data goes to models and how it goes to model and how you can actually build applications which adhere to the highest standards of security that is built into the SQL engine.
Awesome. Great. I love it. So it's not just security for AI, it's the security already built into SQL. So that's great to hear. All right. One more thing to know.
Yeah. So the last thing is building the whole thing together, right? So this is something I have been, again, talking multiple places and getting the customer feedback why SQL and why it's important to actually bring these capabilities to SQL. I always say it's easier to bring AI to data than to bring data to AI. And in this case, it is about the integration story. So you are not building these applications in isolation. We have now native support to most of the famous libraries and frameworks. There's availability with LangChain, with Semantic Kernel, with EF Core. And if you want to do low-code, no-code type RAG applications, you can use the integration that is with Logic Apps. So all of this is available. You can learn more about that in our dev blogs. And what it brings together is your familiar SQL engine coming to it is AI with the built-in security and scalability that you know and you rely on. So this definitely brings the story together for us with one data platform for your AI applications.
I love it. Awesome. Mazma, you never disappoint in a Data Exposed episode. I personally learned a lot. I think our viewers learned a lot. And in a short time, they know the five key things they need to know about SQL and AI. Viewers, if you like this episode, go ahead and give it a like. We're going to put a bunch of links in the description for you to go learn more. Actually, it might just be a couple because Mazma and co have really narrowed it down to help you find what you're looking for. We hope you'll go try this out. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.